Welcome to Warn, today's headlines are Russian aircraft designer to produce two newest PAK FA fighter jets. The Sukhoi aircraft company will produce in 2017 two more Russia's newest PAK FA, T-50, fighters, Russia's Defense Minister Yuri Borisov said on Monday. The work on PAK FA is now at the final stage, and this year we receive the 10th and the 11th planes, which will be tested, and in the future state armament program for 2018 to 2025 we plan first purchases of T-50 fighters, he said during a visit to the Gagarin aircraft plant in Komsomolsk-om-Amur. India, China spoke on turning differences into opportunities, asserting that Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Chinese President Xi Jinping had a very cordial and positive meeting. Foreign Secretary S.J. Shankar on Friday said leaders of the two nations observed that as world becomes more multipolar, it has become more important for them to work together more closely. J.E. Shankar said that during the meeting, both leaders averred that their two nations should not allow their differences to turn into disputes, but rather should turn them into opportunities. Meeting with China was very cordial and positive. Prime Minister Modi thanked President Xi for China's support, which has made possible India's accession to the SCO. At the time of global uncertainty, India-China relations are a factor of stability. And, as the world becomes more multipolar, it has become important for India and China to work together more closely, said J.E. Shankar. There was also an understanding that where we have differences, it was important that differences should not become disputes, and in fact, if they were handled well, could even become opportunities, he added. JK, five terrorists gunned down in URI, ops continue. At least five terrorists have been gunned down so far today, as the Indian Army continues to thwart the stream of cross-border infiltration along the line of control, LOC, at URI sector of Jammu and Kashmir. A massive counter-terror operation led by 4GAK RIV, PARA, is underway, as attempts are being made to sanitize the area and take out untoward elements. In the last 48 hours, the Indian Army has killed 7 terrorists and foiled 6 infiltration bids. In the last 48 hours, infiltration attempts have been foiled at the Gurez, Mokhil, Nagam and URI sectors. 7 armed intruders have been eliminated so far, said the army in a statement. 3 terrorists were killed in Nagam sector on Thursday, while 4 were killed in the Mokhil sector on Wednesday. Also, 2 jawans were injured early Thursday morning in an encounter in URI district where at least 5 terrorists tried to infiltrate the border, but the army foiled their attempt. ISRO readying GSLV Mk3 for human space flight. Castor Ryerngan ISRO is in the process of further improving the capability of its GSLV Mk3 so that it can use this heaviest rocket for human space flight mission once government approval comes, a top scientist said here. GSLV Mk3 is really the vehicle that will be the workhorse in the coming years for primarily launching geosynchronous missions and also very heavy spacecraft in near-Earth missions, K. Castor Ryerngan, former chief of ISRO, told PTI. The Indian Space Research Organisation, ISRO, earlier this week successfully launched from the Sriharikota spaceport, the first developmental flight of GSLV Mk3, capable of launching 4-ton class satellites. ISRO is in the process of further improving the capability of this vehicle. It could go up to a 10-ton kind of capability, said Castor Ryerngan. It was during his tenure as ISRO chairman the GSLV Mk3 was configured and the program secured approval by the Space Commission in the early part of the previous decade. So, this will be a level of vehicle which India will use for most of the requirements of geosynchronous missions. It can take to up to 4 tons and, hopefully with improvements in some of the areas, one can go even beyond 4 tons, he said. With this we want to build our communication satellites. So, it's very tailored for future communication satellites to be launched by India. We will not have to depend on any other foreign launch agency, according to him. India's plan to develop key Iranian port faces U.S. headwinds. Western manufacturers are shying away from supplying equipment for an Iranian port that India is developing for fear the United States may reimpose sanctions on Tehran, Indian officials say, dealing a blow to New Delhi's strategic ambitions in the region. Lying on the Gulf of Oman along the approaches to the Straits of Hormuz, the port of Chabahar is central to India's hopes to crack open a transport corridor to Central Asia and Afghanistan that bypasses arch-rival Pakistan. India committed $500 million to speed development of the port after sanctions on Iran were lifted following a deal struck between major powers and Tehran to curb its nuclear program in 2015. But the state-owned Indian firm that is developing Chabahar is yet to award a single tender for supplying equipment such as cranes and forklifts, according to two government sources tracking India's biggest overseas infrastructure push. These firms dominate the market for customized equipment to develop jetties and container terminals. One official said the first tender was floated in September, but attracted few bidders because of the fear of renewed sanctions. That fear has intensified since January. Now the situation is that we are running after suppliers, one official said, speaking on condition of anonymity because of the sensitivity of matter. A Konkrane spokeswoman declined to comment beyond confirming the company was not involved in the project. Indian Army to induct 108 multi-barrel rocket launchers worth $2 billion. The tender is expected to be issued to firms by the next month, while the acquisition order is expected to be placed within 18 months. Pinaka supplements the existing artillery gun at ranges beyond 30 km with quick reaction time and high rate of fire. Pinaka is developed by state-owned DRDO with private defense firms Tata Power said and L&T. Indian Defense Ministry had placed an order for two regiments IE-36 systems last December. The Army intends to have 22 Pinaka regiments by 2026, including 12 regiments of guided Pinaka. This is an advanced version of the Pinaka, wherein the firing range has been enhanced to 65-plus kilometers from the existing 38 kilometers. India conducted two developmental tests of the 214-millimeter caliber guided Pinaka earlier this year. Six regiment orders will provide major business to state-owned contractors Bharat Earth Movers Limited and the Ordnance Factories Board and private sector defense companies Larsen & Toubro and Tata Power said. BEML supplies vehicles for the rocket launchers while L&T and Tata Power said build launcher systems. Ordnance Factory Board will supply the rocket ammunition. Guided Pinaka will gradually replace SMERCH, which, according to its Russian meaning whirlwind, can flatten an area of 1.1 square kilometers. Guided Pinaka will have a multiplier effect in the battlefield as each individual rocket is guided separately and the commander can change its position and path in every 20 microseconds. HAL B's fifth generation fighter aircraft trainer takes maiden flight. A concept of a future variant of B Systems Hawk trainer jet aircraft has flown for the first time at the company's military aircraft facility in Warden, UK. The concept demonstrator features an upgraded cockpit equipped with B Systems Light HUD, a low-profile head-up display, and a large area display that introduces a new student/pilot training experience. It also features a redesigned wing that increases performance in areas such as turn rates, angles of attack and both takeoff and landing. Other technology advances include increased stores capability, a new set of defensive aids and a range of new flight systems, all aimed at ensuring Hawk continues to provide the edge in fast jet pilot training, as well as offering increased operational utility. The first flight of the aircraft builds on its public debut at Aero India 2017 in Bangalore earlier this year. Steve Timms, Managing Director Defense Information, Training and Services at B Systems said, "The new features in Advanced Hawk have been developed after listening to our customers' views on where fast jet pilot training will go in the future and how we ensure the Hawk continues to meet their requirements. Many of the proposed features of an Advanced Hawk, such as the large area display and new wing, could be achievable as upgrades," he said. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.